Good afternoon, folks. How are you doing? First of all, happy Friday to all of you. It's just after 2 p.m. and here we are on Who Moved the Market. Nimesh is with me. Nimesh, we all know who's moved the market today.
It's and a, what big way, right? And it's a big move.
And a big move. And it's an entity called GQG Partners. Now, yes. Not too many people would have known this name, I think, till about 24 hours back. But yes, over the next 10 odd minutes, we will discuss everything threadbare, this big move on Adani. The question that we are really asking, Nimesh, is that is this a temporary relief or is this a turning point? But you go first with the facts. I mean, just in case people have missed all the block deals and the action. So let's go with what happened first.
Okay, so the news is very simple. Adani promoters yesterday in a block deal in four group companies have managed to raise 15,446 crores. And that too from one of the marquee's global name, that is GQG Partners. Mm-hmm. Well, as you rightly pointed out, not many would know what is GQG Partners. But I'll tell you the name behind GQG Partners, which is Rajiv Jain. Mm-hmm. He's got a tremendous track record managing global markets as well as India markets. So he's got more than 20, 25 years of experience. Yeah. He's worked with Wonderful as well in the past. His track record even in GQG has been fabulous in the last 5-7 years since the establishment. So it's a great name that Adani's have managed to pull in terms of convincing him to put money, or that too not small money, right? It's 15,000 crores of money, close to $2 billion is what he's putting in the Adani Group stock. So that's the key reason why, you know, the whole group is in focus. Mm-hmm. And as we'll go ahead, we'll talk about the banks as well, because that's had a big rub off on the banking sector as well.
Absolutely. So let's start with the basics first. I mean, we're talking about four Adani Group entities, Adani Enterprises, Ports, Adani Green and Adani Transmission. It's very important to keep in mind that GQG Partners has bought stake from the promoters. True. This is not fresh equity that they have subscribed to. So the money is not really coming to the company. Correct. It's going to the Adani family. So just help us with the details there. How much stake have they sold in each entity? Okay. And how are we coming to this figure of 15,400 odd?
So if you look at the four companies where the promoters have sold stake, I'll start with Adani Enterprise first because that was the biggest one. Mm-hmm. 4 crore shares they sold and they've raised close to 5,500 crores.
Okay.
In Adani Ports, they've sold 8.86 crore shares and there they've raised 5,300 crores, close to 5,300 crores. Mm-hmm. In Adani Green, they sold 5.5 crore shares and they've raised close to 2,800 crores.
Okay.
And in Adani Transmission, they sold 2.8 crore shares, raising close to 1,900 crores. So all you put together, it works out to 15,446 crores. Mm-hmm. And that too from a single investor, which is GQG Capital.
Yeah.
Clean trade with no slippage. Most of the blocks were done in the open in the pre-open market, so there was only one-to-one trade. So clearly a good deal where 2-4% is what they've sold across group companies, and they've managed to raise 15,400 crores.
Yeah, and I think that's why the market really stood up to take notice of this. This is a large transaction done on the same day across four entities. It was a statement. I mean, it was a big statement transaction, you know, across these four entities.
More than the money of 15,500 crores, it's the quality of the investor that they've managed to get in.
Yeah.
The GQG partner, the fact that Rajiv Jain has put in money, he's put out in the press release they've mentioned as well, right? I mean, he's spoken about the group, about the potential of this group, and the fact that he believes that Mr. Gautam Adani is one of the brightest entrepreneurs of this century. So I guess that's a big testimony which has come from somebody who's been well respected and well regarded in the global market.
So we'll take this one step at a time. Sure. First, let's talk about the company that he set up, and then we'll talk about the man.
Yeah.
Now, GQG Partners is based out of US, and I think they were set up in 2016. Tell us more, because there's a lot of chatter. Apparently, this investment agency has been a super performer in the last couple of years. So tell us a bit more about that.
It has. So as you rightly pointed out, GQG Partners is founded by Rajiv Jain. Uh-huh. He's now the chairman and CIO of the group.
Yeah.
This particular entity, GQG Partners, globally manages $90 billion.
Yeah. So this is not some small operator we're talking about, some absolutely obscure entity.
Globally, they manage $90 billion.
Mm-hmm.
In emerging market itself, they manage close to $11 billion.
Okay.
If you look at the India exposure of this particular fund through the emerging market fund, you know, the blue chips of the blue chip names are there in the fund, the likes of ITC, Reliance, HDFC, SBI, Bharti Airtel, Infosys, ICICI Bank, Tata Steel. So they've got the best of the names in India, which they have got exposed to. So A, big fund, $90 billion global money.
Yeah.
B, they have a huge exposure in the emerging market. and they are a big investor in the Indian markets as well.
Got that. Now, I did a little bit of research as well on the man, because, you know, typically markets are made up of men and women, of course.
Of course.
And as you mentioned, this name, apparently, you know, the track record goes back about 23 years.
Yeah.
So, Mr. Rajiv Jain moved to the States back in the 1990s, I believe. He did his MBA there from the University of Florida. And then he went on to work for a Swiss investment house. And he worked there for about, 20 odd years?
Yeah, so that's wonderful. You know, one of the biggest names in the financial mm-hmm. market, well regarded. And he was the one who actually built up wonderful and what it was, you know, in those 20 years. So that's the kind of track record we're talking about, Rajiv Jain. Mm-hmm. And after he moved out of GQ, after he moved out of wonderful and mm-hmm. launched GQG, in just 6-7 years, the fund has reached an AUM of $90 billion. You know, that speaks for the man and kind of, you know, vision he has, and the way he executes and takes exposure into various countries. And can you imagine, for him right now, the biggest underweight is US tech. That's the kind of conviction he has. And, you know, let's bet on companies which are like going to see a big run up and not who are already been seen a big move. So
apparently,
that's the kind of a contra view that he's been taking up.
Apparently, he specializes in picking out companies. I mean, bargain blue chips, as they're called. He specializes in picking out companies when perhaps they're at their worst, and then looks at playing turnaround stories. That's one thing that's said about him. The other aspect is just the manner in which his funds have performed, and that's nothing to laugh about. He's also been the Morningstar, top fund manager. He's been chosen as that for 2023. He was chosen as the top fund manager in 2012 as well, when he was with Vantapol. Just want to pull up one statistic. Now, the GS GQG Partners International Opportunities Funds, which is their international fund, their global fund, that has outperformed, a lot of the major large cap funds put together. I mean, the numbers will come up for you. This fund's returned almost 11%, whereas the average is about 6.9. If you're looking at the MSCI World Index, X of US, then that's underperformed. So, I guess the credentials are all there, Nimesh. It's just a question of figuring. And let's not forget this. They've also come in now, and it's fine for Mr. Jain to sound very optimistic now.
Yeah.
We have that quote that you referred to as well, right? Where he's calling Mr. Gautam Adani the entrepreneur of this generation.
Yes.
But optimism always is associated with a cost.
The cost, right?
I mean, and he's bought this at what? 80% below peak valuation?
This is what I've learned in this market in the last 20 years. Bhav Bhagwan Che. This is well said by a lot of Gujarat investors.
Yes.
Bhav Bhagwan Che.
Yes.
At a price, you will find a good buyer if there is a value in that asset. And that's what is actually worked. In this case of Adani Group stocks.
While we discuss this, we must also keep in mind that there's one huge development that we're focusing on for the purpose of this chat. But please bear in mind that there are simultaneous proceedings that are taking place at SEBI. There's a court ruling as well, just to jog your memory, just to keep that, you know, part of the context alive as well. The Supreme Court has told SEBI that SEBI needs to conduct its probe into, of course, whether there's any violation in the securities law whatsoever by the Adani Group, and submit its report in 2 months' time. That report gets submitted to a special panel, and then we'll see, which way that story unfolds. That needs to be kept on board as well while anyone is analyzing this group or these stocks. But let's talk about another, ripple down effect, which is how some of the index providers, like let's say MSCI, how they are going to view this development. So what happens as they adjust their holdings and their weights?
So, you know, as a normal precedence, mm-hmm. whenever you see a promoter stake sale mm-hmm. and when the free float goes up, mm-hmm. you know, the likes of MSCI, FTSE, they take note of it and they try to increase the weight of those stocks as well. Mm-hmm. So that's something what Citi has written in the note to his clients today morning. I'll just quote the Citi note as well. You mm-hmm. know, the Citi note very clearly says that after the stake sale, which has happened in the four group companies yesterday, there is a very high chance that the free float will go up in all the four companies.
Okay.
And that will lead to inflows in all the four stocks. That's the broad line they've mentioned. And there's a possibility that this all changes will happen in the forthcoming May review.
Okay.
So MSCI does this review every quarterly or every six months.
Every
6 months.
Yeah,
so they did it in Feb, now it will happen in May. So that's when Citi expects there will be some changes in terms of weight increases mm-hmm. in the four group stocks. Now, mm-hmm. In terms of individual, how much it can impact in terms of flows in Adani ports, mm-hmm. Citi is estimating an inflow of between $70 to $80 million.
Okay.
As far as Adani Enterprise is concerned, they expect an inflow of between $90 to $100 million.
Okay.
And for Adani Green, mm-hmm. they estimate the inflows between $40 to $50 million.
Okay.
Only in Adani Transmission, mm-hmm. while there were some changes in the last review, now City believes that because of these changes, there is a very high chance that the outflow which is supposed to happen in Adani Transmission,
right,
that will be now half of what it was supposed
okay.
to be. So
okay.
these are the major changes what city is expecting, which will happen in the May review. Because of the fact that the promoter holding has gone down, the free float has gone up, uh-huh. so the weight will increase for all the Adani Group stocks.
Which is very interesting, because as you were saying, that for some of these Adani entities, the fear or the worry was yeah. that the weights will decrease,
True.
Given how the stocks have been performing and given sort of a lot of the other parameters. But Citi at least believes that it's going to be the reverse this time around. Another sort of corollary to this whole development is how bank stocks are doing so well today, Nimesh.
Yep.
So tell us more. I mean, I know SBI is one of the key lenders in terms of Indian lenders, yeah. and they have a lot of foreign debt as well. So SBI, who else? I mean, which other lenders should we keep in mind?
So if you look at banks, and as you rightly pointed out, you know, there has been a big rub-off effect on the mm-hmm. on the banking stocks as well.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact is, ever since this Adani saga started, all the banks have underperformed, whether it's
yeah.
PSU banks or private banks. And
yeah.
this too, despite the strongest quarter three for most
yeah.
of the banking stocks,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
from that context, I think this is a big relief rally for the bank stocks as well.
Mm-hmm.
Quickly,
mm-hmm.
if I run through the exposure of these PSU mm-hmm. banks to the Adani Group,
mm-hmm.
SBI has got an exposure of 0.8% of the total loan book.
Mm-hmm.
The size would be very small, of 27,000 crores of total
mm-hmm.
exposure.
Mm-hmm.
For Axis Bank, the exposure is 9,000 crores.
Mm-hmm.
Again, you know, just little over 1.2%
mm-hmm.
is their exposure is. REC, close to 7,000 crores. PNB, 7,000 crores. Bank of Baroda has an exposure of close to 5,300 crores. And IndusInd Bank has an exposure of close to 4,200 crores.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of percentage exposure of the book,
mm-hmm.
REC is the highest. And Bank of Baroda is the lowest. So that sums
yeah.
up the kind of exposure you have for
yeah.
the Adani Group within the PSU stocks.
That's important to keep in mind, because
yeah.
ultimately the exposure is, you know, the important part is how much of your book is exposed to Adani.
And it's not very large,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
I mean, as I said, the percentage of the book,
hmm.
it ranges between 0.6, which is the lowest
yeah.
for BOB, and
hmm.
the highest is 1.7 for REC. So
yeah.
that's the range for all the exposure of the PSU banks. As far as Adani
right.
Group is concerned, so it's not very large. It was more of a sentiment effect.
Yeah.
I mean, people were scared. I think that
mm.
has now behind the fact that they've raised so much of money,
mm.
and that too from one of the market's investor.
Mm.
I think that's why you're seeing a bit of a relief rally in the PSU banks today.
So speaking of sentiment, Nimesh, let's actually end with that. I mean, beyond all the headlines and the news, you speak to so many people on and off the record. So let me ask you the question that we began with: is this event just a temporary relief, or can it be a turning point? What's the street view you're getting on this?
See, the street view is simple.
Mm-hmm.
I feel that this is a turnaround point, so
okay.
to speak. You know,
okay.
And I'll tell you why. Last mm-hmm. week, same time, you know, there was extreme fear in the market.
Oh,
extreme
yes.
pessimism,
yes.
extreme fear in the market.
Yeah.
And because of the fact that, you know, now they've managed to raise this money,
mm-hmm.
things have improved at the
mm-hmm.
margin. I think this is going to be a turning point.
Uh-huh.
So look at Adani Enterprise per se.
Mm.
This week, beginning
mm.
of Monday,
mm.
the stock was 1111. Today it's quoting at 1850.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
The way PSU banks and banks have rebounded today.
Yeah.
See, what has happened on ground, Subi, for a lot of investors, forget
mm-hmm.
the traders, even for the investors,
mm-hmm.
all of a sudden you're seeing a big M2M gain.
Yeah.
You're seeing a lot
yeah.
of losses.
Yeah.
And that has turned.
And
actually makes a, you know, investor a little bullish. The sentiment
yeah,
changes,
yeah,
the
yeah.
fear goes out, you become more confident. So that's what has changed, you know, from
mm.
extreme fear,
yeah.
I think there is hope back in the market.
I think we saw signs of that even before the announcement. I mean, the Adani
yeah.
Group stocks from every day being limit down, there was some bottom fishing that had actually started. So perhaps
yeah.
that was a sign of things to come.
Yeah.
Nimesh, thank you very much. I think
thank
this
you.
Has been really, really helpful. It brings us up to speed on the story so far, but you never know. इस कहानी में बहुत से मोड़ आते हैं एंड यू नेवर नो व्हेन द नेक्स्ट टर्न इज अराउंड व्हिच कॉर्नर बट वी विल कीप यू अपडेटेड दैट्स आवर प्रॉमिस टू यू राइट हियर ऑन सीएनबीसी टीवी 18
वन थिंग अगेन यू नो आई जस्ट रिपीट राजीव जैन हैज थॉट अगेन भाव भगवान छे सो भाव इज द अल्टीमेट यू नो थिंग दैट यू नीड टू वॉच व्हेन यू बाय सम स्टॉक
एवरीथिंग इज गुड एट
अ प्राइस
एब्सोल्युटली ऑलराइट निमेश थैंक यू वेरी मच आई विल लीव यू टू नाउ एंजॉय द रेस्ट ऑफ योर आफ्टरनून एंड स्टार्ट रैपिंग अप प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द वीकेंड फॉर नाउ थैंक्स फॉर ट्यूनिंग इन डू रिमेंबर यू कैन कैच दिस एंटायर कॉन्वर्सेशन on the CNBCTV18.com website in the Binge section. So do remember to look out for us in Binge. We will, of course, keep seeing you every day, all weekdays, 2 p.m. with something interesting from the markets. Remember, this is a show that's called Who Moved the Market?